guys, I'm Sam, this is Chris, and thanks for tuning into our channel where we explore achieving financial freedom and wealth through a three-part strategy. Earn more, spend less, and invest the rest. Today's video is all about dividends. So Chris, tell us more about what we will be discussing today.
Well, like you said, we're talking about dividends. And anybody on the journey to financial freedom needs to be aware of dividends because they're a great source of passive income. And that's what we're trying to do, is create income streams. But there are some significant pitfalls that you can run into if you're not aware of all the fine details of dividends.
Okay, great. So let's dig in and get started with the most basic question. What are dividends?
So dividends are cash distributions made by a company to its shareholders.
Okay, so I noticed that you said cash and not earnings. Is there a reason why?
Yeah, because most definitions will tell you that a dividend is a portion of earnings paid to shareholders. That's not always the case. Sometimes it's more just cash. So a company is actually paying more in dividends than it makes in earnings, which could be a huge red flag.
Okay, so if it's a red flag, it's bad business practice. We're assuming that the company is taking out debt in order to pay those dividends.
Yeah, so they're either using cash off its balance sheet or borrowing money.
Okay.
And leveraging the balance sheet even further and not actually adding value to the investor.
Why would a company do this?
So a lot of people are chasing dividends. There's a lot of retirees on fixed income that rely on dividends to live off of. So what happens when a company cuts its dividend is investors bail, stock prices drop, and it looks very bad on the company's management. So management will do whatever they can to continue paying dividends, continue increasing dividends, to continue retaining these investors, even if it means borrowing lots of money, paying these dividends, and really getting them in a bad position.
Okay, so dividends do not necessarily mean a good company.
Absolutely not.
Okay, cool. All right, so we are value investors. We're always looking for a good long-term investment to add to our portfolio. When do we buy dividend stocks?
Okay, we generally don't buy a stock just because it pays a dividend. We buy a stock when it's a great company, it's led by a honest, good management team, it's got great competitive advantages, and we understand it well enough that we can put a fair value on it and buy it at a discount to that value. Now, ideally, we like companies to retain all its earnings, reinvest into the business, and grow that business and compound our money year after year. Dividend stocks, dividend companies, they're paying you a portion of that earnings, and then that creates a little bit more work for us because we have to find investments to reinvest those earnings or reinvest those dividends so that we can actually get the compounding factor, compounding effect, which we're all looking for as investors.
So, okay, when we do invest in dividend stocks, what are some of the benefits that we get out of that investment?
Well, for a lot of people, they get regular cash flow. Now, I just mentioned Sam and I aren't looking for cash flow. We're reinvesting this, so that doesn't really impact us too much. But what is a significant benefit to us is that it de-risks the investment. So every time they pay a dividend, we're getting a portion of our initial investment off the table, and we can reinvest that into other investments.
Okay, cool. So if we were to take like a super simplified example, let's say we bought a stock for $10 and then it was giving us a dividend yield every year of $1 back. So at the end of a 10-year period, we would essentially have all of our money off the table and be playing with like the house's money. Is that right?
Exactly.
Okay.
Exactly. And there's other ways we get money off the table, cash off the table, cash out of our investment. And we'll go over those in future videos. But yes, absolutely.
Okay, fantastic. All right, so we talked about what is a dividend, we talked about the definition, we talked about the benefits. So what are some of the pitfalls or red flags that people need to avoid?
Well, like we already mentioned, it's really when a company is paying more in dividends than it is in earnings. That is a huge red flag. So one of the ways we check that is by looking at its payout ratio, a company's payout ratio. So a payout ratio is a pretty simple equation. It's just dividends over the company's earnings. Ideally, you want this ratio to be fairly small. So anything when it gets 80, 90%, sometimes 100% or more when a company is actually borrowing money, it's a huge red flag. Okay. And we need to avoid those.
All right, great. Okay, well, awesome. That's all really valuable information. I think that's good for today. Guys, we hope that you found this video useful and that you got a few little nuggets of knowledge to take away with you. Thanks for tuning into our channel. If you liked the video, give us a thumbs up, subscribe to our channel, and leave a comment below. We hope to see you next time. And remember, earn more, spend less, and invest the rest.